So this bridge over River Dhansiri in Kuda village, this is one of the oldest British built bridges in the state of Nagaland and perhaps even in the northeast. Nobody in Nagaland will now know when exactly it was built, which year exactly it was built. But we can assume from the elders' narration that this might have been built during 1937 or 38. And we understand that the British built this bridge for use during the war. So the Second World War was at the time at its peak. So the First World War, Second World War, they're preparing for the Second World War. And so we assume, our elders assume that this was built somewhere in 1937, 38, plus minus 1 or 2 years, because nobody knew for sure. I wish some researchers would dig into the past, the colonial bridges, and find out when exactly this was built. I am interested to know that also.
Okay.
And so the quality that you have seen, it stood for so many years, nearly 100 years.
Mm-hmm.
And during the great flood of 2016 and 17, almost all the bridges, they broke down. This also, the joint also fell down, but it got laid over each other.
Mm-hmm.
And it stood the test of time. You see, so many vehicles ran over it, thousands and thousands every day over it, even after it shifted its position. And so now we know that the British built bridges, the quality is extremely, extremely good.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So I believe and I wish the bridge, this new one, 120 meters span, built by Rokuru Angami, I believe this will match the quality of the British construction ability.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure this will last, because I personally live nearby the bridge.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the landowner who donated my portion, the west side, mm-hmm. of the land for this bridge.
Mm-hmm.
And so I come here almost every week,
mm-hmm.
and I do my own inspection,
mm-hmm.
as a layman.
Mm-hmm.
So I noticed that he has built a bridge, very special quality. What the DPR has not specified, he has done beyond that, adding more rod, adding more quality rod, and then he finally added two more, at both ends, two more foundation base pillars, which were not in the DPR. So that was a very good, great sacrifice on his part, because a pillar of this quality, a single pillar of this quality, might be costing him 2 crores. Or above. So that means he's spending more than 4 to 5 crores. So will a contractor easily contribute or sacrifice that much? So I think this gentleman, this contractor, Rokuru, he has done a great job constructing this bridge. We are happy. The people of Kuda village are very happy that he came to construct this bridge, and the people of Kuda village are also happy, and we are also grateful to the government of Nagaland for taking special initiative to construct this bridge, which was completed by the contractor on record time.
All right, thank you.